let's try to add a few more things about this adjust tool. Say for example, remember last time I told you how to lock the selection and adjust the object. This time I will try to do it in a little bit different manner. I'll just try to say undo one step back. It's not compulsion, you can try this on some other object, but here I'll just say undo one step back. And instead of locking the selection also, it's okay, even if it is locked, not an issue. If I just want to use this adjust command, now you can see the control minus is the hotkey. Okay, so you can directly go and try to press the control minus also to get the adjust tool. And or otherwise, same way, pull down menu, edit and reshape, and from there you can also achieve the adjust command or otherwise hotkey. So let's click on the icon, and now you read the prompt. It is written at the bottom of your screen. Click an arc or edge or draw a line to adjust the selected elements to it. So there are three possibilities: that you can show the arc or edge as a boundary up to whom you want to adjust the object, or you can draw a line by selecting two segments. Okay, so sorry, you can draw a virtual line with the point selecting two nodes. Okay, as per your choice, anywhere on the screen. So I'll show you all these possibilities, obviously. But prior to that, let's try to work with the first combination, that is click an arc or edge. So this is my edge. Okay, so what you have to do is don't keep your pencil on the empty part of the drawing and pick, because that will activate your second option, this draw a line option. Because I want to extend this object up to this periphery or the edge, I just have to click on this with the semi-filled icon of the pencil. You know it very well, hollow pencil and semi-filled. That means inside the pencil, only one vertical line you can see. So click on this and you will see your element got adjusted. Okay, so it's very simple. What I'm going to show you, that please try first of all this much of thing, and then see the next part. Here I'm just going to show you some other possibilities in the adjust, because you should remember, say for example, I'm just going to select one more object with the shift key. Okay, and now two objects are selected, and I'm just going to say Control Shift D, drag a copy, and I'm just going to randomly copy them somewhere on this side. Okay, fine. So I've just copied them on the random. Now what is the interesting part, or what exactly I'm going to explain this time? That adjust is not always going to be extend. It can be either trimming or extending the selected entities or objects up to the boundary which you are trying to show. So in this case, if I want to remove this part, okay, and I want to keep this outside area, this becomes my boundary, right? So we have not studied how to use the normal trim tool. So this is what I'm just explaining about the adjust again. That is nothing but this adjust tool. Okay, so just try to click on this, and remember this time what we have to do is click on this vertical edge. Remember the physical intersection will be one more important thing which you have to note in this case, because I want to adjust. Last time there was no physical intersection, it was an imaginary edge which was considered and the object was adjusted. This time this line is actually intersecting and passing or cutting these two horizontal lines. So with the Mercedes cursor, if I click on, not Mercedes, I'm very sorry for that. With the semi-filled icon, if I click on this particular segment, you can see ArchiCAD will try to identify which portion is supposed to be smaller in length, that will get deducted or removed or trimmed, and the remaining part will get adjusted. So this is what you should remember about the adjust, that adjust works in a dual mode. Either it will extend or it will trim as per the possibility, and you will get the end product. So you have to keep an eye on this. Right? So this is how the adjust tool works. Of course, later we'll try to study a few more possibilities. Now what I'm going to do is these two segments, anyway they are of no use, because I just want to show you how this thing can be get done. I'll hit the delete key from the keyboard, so they'll get deleted because I want to get rid of them. So get prepared with this tool and try to follow then the next clip. So that in the next clip, we'll try to see how to then complete this room and then start adding some door or window puncture by using some copy and trimming techniques. Again and again, I'm repeating that all these things which we are doing is to understand the basics of ARCHICAD for its drafting and editing techniques. Okay, you are not supposed to in reality draw the walls or door windows by using such a complicated process. But this is just to get familiar with ARCHICAD for its basic drafting and editing methods. Fine, so please complete this much of exercise and then follow the next clip.